Good morning, everyone. This is Glenn Reynolds, the Outdoor Bum, and I'm coming to you with This Week in the Outdoors. Today is March the 7th. It's a Friday. A little bit dreary outside, but you know what? We can all have a lot of fun things to do this weekend, and I'm bringing you a few of them to talk to you about, and hopefully it'll inspire you to get outdoors. Now, with that being said, I have Georgia on my mind. And I'm excited because that's my home state, but I have found some pretty cool things that I think I want to bring to you. If you're there in Georgia, it's a great opportunity. You have some great resources there. If you're passing through, these could be some really cool things to do on your way through. So without further ado, let's get it started. First things first, we got to cover our sponsors. And with Georgia on my mind, my first sponsor is Blue Ridge Bird Seed Company. They have the Birdman blend, which is seeds for your feeder, and it's fantastic. The quality of the product is beyond compare, and I will tell you, if you use it, you'll have the migration stopping in your yard, and the birds coming around all summer long. It's a great opportunity to be able to view wildlife year-round, and Jamie knows that. She's put together a great product, and she can ship it to you anywhere, so you don't just have to be a local buyer. You can go to BlueRidgeBirdSeed.com and order seed from there. Jamie will get it shipped to you, and you can experience that great quality of product and the results by having lots of birds in your yard. That's BlueRidgeBirdSeed.com. Second sponsor is Graxaw Game Gear, light, fast, and efficient gear for the backcountry explorer. I will tell you, Austin, he does a great job with his products too. He is an engineer by trade. He puts together product. He meticulously tests these out. He even has let me try some of it, test them out, give him some information back on the products. I'll tell you, they're fantastic, and I would not be afraid to use them. In fact, I take them on my trips out into the backcountry when I go on my hunting and exploring trips. So that's Graxaw.com, G-R-A-K-S-A-W. And Austin, he'll get you taken care of too. Third sponsor, Central Missouri Power Wash. Mid-Missouri's number one choice for your home exterior cleaning needs. From the roof to the ground, we've got your exterior cleaning needs covered. So we use a soft wash system, which is easy on your home. We're not going to be out there carving up your siding and doing other things that inexperienced people do. What you want, if you want a perfect-looking product, perfect-looking home, give us a call. We're going to take care of you. We've been doing it now for about 7 years, and with that experience, we know how to clean, we know how to do it right. So don't be afraid to give us a call, centralmissouripowerwash.com. And our final sponsor is Glenn's Home Pros. Glenn's Home Pros is your one-stop shop for your home maintenance needs. So what we do is we go through and review your home, take a look at all, make a list of all the stuff that needs to be done on your home on a maintenance schedule, and we put that together. We come back to you, we'll let you know what all needs to be done, when it needs to be done, and then we decide how to work with you on getting those maintenance needs covered so that you can focus on living your life and doing the things that you find fun. So that if you want to get that, have that level of service and take those worries off your place, go to glenshomepros.com. So now, with all that being done, sponsors, on to the rest of it. So today, I want to start off with something that put that put Georgia back on my mind, particularly yesterday. I was scrolling through my Facebook feed, and I came across a place called Jared's Place, and I thought it was pretty neat. So I got to researching it, and it is a fantastic facility that Jared has put together. I believe it's Jared Harrison. It's in Somerville, Georgia, which is about a half an hour south of Chattanooga, or an hour and a half northwest of Atlanta, up 75. And what he has is over 200 acres, and he's built, from what I can tell, over 20 miles of trails that you can go and take your mountain bike and ride around on. Now, a bike park is cool. There's places that you can go to and just ride your mountain bike that's really neat, and it's a great opportunity. But what's special about this is they've come to and tried to give more of a Whistler type of experience in Georgia. So you have quite a bit of elevation gain and decline, and they have a shuttle service that'll shuttle you about halfway up the mountain. So if you go up there and you ride the shuttle up, get out on your bike, go for a ride. They have everything from jumps to zooming trails where you can just roll right along. You ride down to the bottom, catch a shuttle, get back up to the top. If you want to climb to the top, you got about 450 feet of elevation gain to get to the top, and then you've got whole bombing way down, and they've got big air tracks. So if you want to get out, go explore, that's Jared's Place, and it is Georgia's first bike park as a business. Now, it is a business, so you do have to pay to enter. I believe it's $30 if you don't use the shuttle, and $50 if you do. But the shuttles, like I said, they run every 15 minutes. It's kind of like a ski park where you go, you catch a lift up, and you can bomb back down as many times as you want. They also have built facilities for the more experienced riders to be able to go and do your more technical riding, coming off of rocks, jumps, lots of drop-ins. But they also have built facilities for your beginning level riders. So if you want to get out there and just go and experience some really neat mountain biking, I would tell you, I think Jared's Place is a good way to look that up, and you can find them online. They've also done a few podcasts out there. In fact, I was listening to one, how he got his start, and it's pretty cool. Jared actually, well, he had started out building BMX bike tracks and did that for a while. And then left from that, he actually did comedy for a number of years and then got burned out on that. Then he went and came back to Georgia and ended up bought some property and started building bike tracks for him and his friends. And I believe this is the third or fourth property that he's owned, and the opportunity presented itself for him to turn this into a business. And so it seems to be pretty legit. So if you get an opportunity, go and explore Jared's Place this weekend. So now the second one I want to talk about is very unique to Georgia, and the Apalachicola, the Flint River, Chattahoochee, and the Okmulgee Rivers. You have shoal bass, or shoalies as you call them. And actually the shoalie was designated as the state's riverine fish, and signed into law by Governor Brian Kemp in 2020. And it is a bass that lives on, as per its name, around the shoals in those river systems. It's very unique. It's a hard fighting bass. And if you want to go out and have a lot of fun and do some unique fishing, go target these species. You can get in your kayak, float down the river and hit the shoals, or and then once you get to the shoal area, park your kayak, get out, walk up to the edge and start fishing your structure. And it's just like any other bass. They use the same type of lures. They particularly enjoy the shoal bass, particularly enjoy to eat crawfish, fathead minnows, golden shiners, the leeches. That's the same stuff that most of the other bass eat. And so you can use your plastic worms, spinner baits, buzz baits, jerk baits. You can use any of those and work those shoals, work it around the structure, any kind of rock ledges, things like that. Be great opportunity to go out and catch those fish. And they are hard fighting because they live right there in the fast current. So they get a workout every day. And so you hook into those and you're sure going to know it. And besides the fact that it's a unique species to Georgia. And so you get out, go find those fish, go and explore the outdoors. Never know. You may hear the turkeys gobbling while you're out there. Man, I love it this time of year. Turkey's going to be out there. I can't do it. I do a terrible turkey gobble. But I love to hear them gobble. And anytime I can get outdoors to listen to that is a great opportunity. So going out there and fishing on the shoals, you might be able to hear those yourself. Now, one thing I do want to warn you about is Georgia's trespassing laws on rivers that are non-navigable, which means you can't get a commercial river boat up through there, then the law states that the property owner that borders the river, his property line goes to the center of the river. And the Flint River in particular, it's become quite the divisive topic, because some areas have been chained off. Landowners have either bought both sides of the river, or two landowners have gotten together and strung up cables across it and preventing access. And that is legal. And if you float over that or get into it, you are trespassing. So please know the areas before you jump in and decide to take a big float down the river. Make sure that you're not going to get yourself into a precarious situation or arrested. So that those are some laws that are set into place, so be very wary of that. Now, shoal bass, I've seen some videos. I didn't do it when I was there, but that's something that I'm going to get back at some point, and I'm going to be doing some shoal bass fishing because I'd like to add that one on or tick that one off the bucket list. All right, the final thing that I want to talk about is the hunting aspect of this video, and that's feral hog hunting. This time of year, as we've said, there's not many other things, other opportunities out there, and feral hogs are an invasive species. They were introduced by the Spanish back during the conquistador days, Ponce de Leon, and I believe, can't remember if DeSoto made it through Georgia or not, but anyways, they dropped them off as a food source, and of course, Ossabaw Island has very world-famous hogs that are a delicacy, and the rest of Georgia, hogs have pretty much populated throughout. And so when you make your, if you're looking for something to do, make sure you know your laws, but you potentially can go feral hog hunting this time of year, particularly on private land. And in Georgia, you can hunt public land. You can shoot hogs during whatever season is available with the weapons that are legal to use during that season. So you technically during squirrel season, you can hunt hogs. And actually a lot of people do. They'll get a 22 Magnum and use that to hunt them. Or you can hunt them with your bows during that time of year. I consider hogs an environmental terrorist. I've been in the outdoors quite a bit. I've seen the destruction that they can do. Man, when they go through and root up an area, like they completely turn over the soil, expose everything, and like deaden it to the use by other native species. And they are opportunistic feeders. So any ground-dwelling bird, any nest, they're going to go through and they're going to vacuum that up. They come through an area and they eat everything. They root for the worms. They catch snakes and eat them, which... It's pretty bad. They even catch deer fawns and they will kill them and eat them too. So anything they can catch and eat, they will. And there's really not any native predator for them. So they're pretty much at ease, given the opportunity to go do whatever they want. So it's up to us as people to manage them and beat them back. Now here in Missouri, they've done a great job of trapping them. And actually a lot of people do catch them in traps. They'll bait them up with corn and use, I think the boar buster traps are what they use, which is a big net that drops down and you can usually catch the sounder, which is what a group of pigs is called. And so with that, they want to remove them out to allow the native species to continue to grow and thrive. And if we can get these terrorists out of the native environment, it is sure will be helpful. So one cool opportunity that may still be going on is you have guides that will go and take people on nighttime hunts, which is legal to hunt hogs. You can use thermal imaging scopes, and they go bait them up, wait for the hogs to come out into the fields at night, which they feel safe doing because they can see better than we can at night, and they know there's not predators out there. Well, then you wait for them to get out there, and then you take them out, harvest them off of the property, and that helps out the landowners and the farmers and our native species. So if you get an opportunity and you're just looking for something to do, some kind of hunting to do to get outside, feral hog hunting. Look into those opportunities. There's plenty of them around throughout the state of Georgia, and our native species will be thankful, and I'm sure many landowners would be thankful too if you come out and hunt them. So feral hogs. And with that, I appreciate your time. I hope you guys get out, go explore the outdoors. This is Glenn Reynolds, the Outdoor Bum, and I'm signing off.